Hey everyone, welcome to the 7th episode of How to Create Your Own First Person Shooter Single Player Game. In this episode, we are going to give our enemy limited ammo and have him reload with a reload animation to give our player the chance to run away. If you want to follow along with this series, check out the card that displays at the top right for the playlist. If you like the tutorials I create, then make sure to like and comment and subscribe down below and join the Discord. If you want to support my creation of games and YouTube tutorials, then consider pledging on Patreon. First thing we are going to do when we have Unity open is to download our reload animation from mixamo.com. So in Unity, go into your assets folder and expand your imported assets folder. Then go down to your JAMO character folder and expand it. Then go down to the models folder and expand it. When you see the JAMO low poly model, right click on it and then click on show in Explorer in the drop down. Once you've opened it in Explorer, leave it and go to your internet browser and search for mixamo.com, or just download the rig below, as we are going to use mixamo.com as per our previous animation. So once logged into mixamo.com, click on upload and drag your JAMO low poly FBX file from the folder window that we opened inside the upload box in Mixamo. Once your character is uploaded and you see your character animating, then the rig works and we can click on next and search for a reload animation and choose one that is most suited to the gun that our enemy is holding. I will choose this one as I think it will work best in a future episode where we will show you how to make it look better with an animator rigger. So once we have chosen our reload animation, we can click download and download our new reload animation. Then click open in the folder. Back in Unity, in your assets folder, expand the animations folder and drag and drop your downloaded reload animation from the open folder into your animations folder, where your other animations are. Expand the asset and go down to your mixamo.com motion and click on it and duplicate it with Ctrl plus D and rename it to reload and delete the original asset. We now have our new reload animation. So now we need to create a new empty state and transition in our animator so that our enemy can reload when we need him to, and also use our downloaded animation. So in Unity, go into your assets folder and then expand your animations folder and expand animator controller folder and double click on the enemy AC to open it. Once the animator controller is open, you can right click anywhere again and click create state and create a new empty state and call it reload. Click on the new reload, then go in your animations folder and drag and drop the reload animation into the motion box in the inspector window. Then at the top left in the animator window, click on parameters and click on the plus to add another parameter, which will be a trigger, and call it reload. Now that we've done that, we can create the transitions. So in the animator controller, right click on the shoot state and make a transition to the reload state and click on it. In the inspector window, untick has exit time, and down in the conditions, set the condition to reload. Right click on the reload state and make a transition and connect it with the run state and click on it. In conditions, set the condition to is running and set the condition to be true and make a transition from run state to reload state and untick has exit time and call the reload condition. Make another transition from the reload state and connect it with the idle state and click on it, and in the inspector window, in conditions, set the condition to is running and set this to false and make a transition from the idle to reload and click on the transition, and in the inspector, untick has exit time and call the reload trigger. Now we are done with our animator once again. Go down to your scripts folder and expand it and double click on the enemy AI script to open it up in Visual Studio. Once your enemy AI script is open, we start at the top and under private float last attack equals 0, we can create a new header and call it reload. So we will type header reload. Now we will create our variables. We will need reload speed, ammo amount, and reload amount. The reload speed has to be the same as the animation time, which will be 3.3. If you go back into Unity and in your assets folder, go into your animations folder and then expand your animations folder and click on the reload animation. You'll see the information displayed in the inspector window. Now that we know our value for reload speed, we can type private float reload speed equal 3.3F, and private int ammo amount equal 5, and private int reload amount equal 5. Then down in the shoot target method, inside of the if time.time is greater than last attack plus attack rate, then after last attack equal time.time, create a new if statement. If ammo amount is greater than 0, to check if we have ammo, and then also cut and paste this section and delete the debug.log as we won't be needing this. Then type ammo amount minus minus to reduce the ammo. Then after this if statement, we are going to use the else if statement to check if we ran out of ammo. So we will type else if ammo amount is less or equal than 0, then inside we will wait so that our enemy waits a bit longer as he reloads, and we type reload and press control and period to generate the method. Before we go into the reload method, let's finish our shoot target method. So after the if statement, we are going to type else, and in our else statement, we will type chase target to call our chase target method when our enemy is not reloading or shooting the target. Then in our generated reload method, delete the throw new not implemented exception, and then we will type get component in children animator set trigger reload. This is all we need to make our method work, but we will run into a problem that our reload animation plays twice when triggered. But that is because we are not giving our animation enough time to play before the next function. And we will fix this by using a coroutine and create a new method after a reload method for our reload animation by typing private IEnumerator called reload animation. And inside our method, we will type yield return new wait 4 seconds reload speed to give our animation time to finish playing, and then ammo amount equal reload amount. Now we need to reference this in our reload method to make this work. So in the reload method at the top, we will start by typing if it isn't the get component in children animator dot get current animator state info 0 dot is name is reload, which means if the enemy reload state isn't activated, then cut and paste get component in children animator dot set trigger reload inside the curly braces of the if statement, and then press enter and type start coroutine reload animation to call the reload animation method. If we had to play the game now, we would realize that the enemy AI will be gliding towards the player while reloading. So the best practice would be to create a state machine for this. But we will cover this in a future episode and fix this issue with a bool. So go to the top where the variables are, and by the reload header, create a new private bool called isReloading and give it the default value of false. Head to the reload method, and inside of the state check, if getComponent in children animator.getCurrent animator state, type isReloading equal true. Then it will call the IEnumerator we have set up. And after it has weighted the reload speed amount, then we want to set the isReloading equal to false, as we are done with reloading. Inside of the engageTarget method, we then want to also have an extra check. Cut if distance, and then write if isn't loading, then paste. Now that we have adjusted our script, we can save and go back into Unity, and then go into the scene view, and then press play to test. Once you shoot the enemy chases you and shoots back. You should also see that the enemy is reloading when out of ammo, and the player should be able to run away while the enemy is reloading and the enemy is chasing again after reloading. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, join the Discord channel if you want to learn more with game development, and if you would just like to join the community or ask for any advice. Check out all the links down below for all of the information. Source code link is also down below, as well as the full Git project. Keep well and see you in the next episode. Cheers.